So the idea is now to just show the teaser of what we were going to do in this tutorial session today. For this, I think Chris, you can just start the elephant side.
Yeah, so it's just that one where the teaser in is a framework to perform computation within the network. And for example, you can use NFN to collect sensor data and to compute any statistics, any metrics, etc. And therefore, we set up a kind of edge computing scenario where we have some NFN nodes available. And the user can interact with this NFN nodes asking for a metric, for statistics about data over a given interval of time. Thereby, NFN can also solve the problem finding which data are available in the interval, because that's sometimes the problem with ICN, finding which timestamp is available.
And so the IoT side of this whole session is, of course, the things for the IoT, and for these things we will use boards like these. I mean, you probably don't know these boards, but they're quite famous in our area. So we will use them to measure, for example, the temperature or the humidity in this room, for example, or another room. And of course, I'm not biased, but we will use Wright as an operating system for these boards. These boards, we will run full CCEM or an NDN stack based on two implementations. We have this NDN Wright, developed by UCLA and now in Florida, maybe. And of course, CCLite from Basel. So we will use these stacks on those nodes, and they will speak full CCEM or NDN to some form of a water router. This is, in this case, a Raspberry Pi we will use. So we have different kind of communication. So we are not using Wi-Fi normally in these IoT scenarios. We are using 802.15.4, maybe Windows Zigbee, which is basically the same link layer as this standard. So we need some more translation from this radio into the cable. So we are using the Pi, which is equipped with the transceiver, to communicate with them, and the Pi translate this into the Ethernet or whatever else comes behind this. So that's the IoT part. This will deliver the information, the sensors, temperature, for example, stores it in the Pi, and from there, the NFN side can just do computations, calculations.
The scenario you see here is the goal of the later session, where one part can develop NFN functions to fetch sensor data, the other part will develop on the right side for offering sensor data to the network. And at the end, you can have something like this web page, for example, where you can connect to a gateway node.
Can you increase the size? Because I cannot see it.
Better?
Yeah.
And you can just choose your time interval. So, by clicking this button, now functions calls will be sent. You see here one function call that looks very cryptic, but it's just the UI encoding that makes it look so cryptic, asking for the error with sensor data over the interval. This is specified by here the function list interval service that checks which sensor data are available in this time interval and returns them, and later on you'll find some point result of the sensor data, so we used a using a temperature sensor in this case, and we can at the end plot, for example, the result including the original sensor data and an average value computed on an NFN node. And now we have here parameters that specified for instead of temperature, and obviously the graph is now looking a bit different.
The cool thing is while doing this, I mean, this is, yeah, I have to stress again, this is a demo which is using several components developed by several people, and we just threw them together and worked. I mean, for example, we are using the NDN.js. This website here, so this is also another UCLA thing. From there, the interest gets thrown to an NFT or CCLite. Yeah, but I mean, it could also be NFT, it doesn't matter, it's NDN. And from there, it just gets forwarded to the Pi, and from the Pi to, I think, currently it's running CCLite of these. So they're using so many different components in there. So it's like an mentor test. And it just works, so it's quite amazing. And this is a cool thing actually.
Yeah, and the only common thing is that they all speak in an ICN protocol, and they all have some kind of name conventions, because I need to know the name from the sensor data